No discussion of ACE would be complete without a discussion on security. Now, the ACE application itself, or the ACE applications, scheduler, wizard, and manager, do need certain accesses to run. That's obvious. And if you are installing ACE, the scheduler, wizard, and manager, on the PI server, the trusts and the applications that are in place will operate just fine. You don't have to worry about adding any extra security levels to your system. However, if you're running your scheduler, wizard, and manager, or any one of the components on different computers, you will need to take into account certain security considerations. And for the most part, this revolves around access to the module database. Now, the module database, by default, is owned by the PI admin user. However, you don't really want to give everybody the PI admin user to use if they're just going to be using ACE. So what we recommend you do is you create a user called ACE Sched or ACE Scheduler and set a password for that user. And you create a group called MDB Editor or MDB Editors, and you go into the put the ACE Schedule user in the MDB Editor group, and then finally you go to the DB security table and you give the MDB editor group read-write group access to the PI modules table. Now what that will do is two things. Is it will allow you to put individuals in a group, and that group will have access to do their own appropriate reads and writes from the module database as ACE designers. And it'll also create a user called ACE Scheduler or ACE Sched that will allow you to create a trust so other processes, other machines can come through as that user without necessarily being prompted for username and password. So what you would then do is you want to create a trust to grant access to the user ACE Scheduler or ACE Sched to all workstations that are running the wizard and or the ACE manager. And you want to include, as an alternative, all PI users who are using these applications in the MDB editor group. So you can do one or the other. And also don't forget, if you're running your scheduler on a machine that's separate from the PI server, to create a trust for that. Basically what you want is every workstation that's using ACE, you want to have access to the module database. There is one thing that we bring up to every class that we teach in ACE, and that is this sort of what we call general security warning. ACE is a very powerful application, and one of the things that you'll notice about ACE tags is they don't have a specific point source like other interface tags. Which means, and you can infer this from the fact that it doesn't have a specific point source, ACE can write to any tag on the PI server. There are no real limitations to what ACE can read from and write to, as long as it, as long as it can see the tags. And so, anybody that can write an ACE calculation can alter their data. Now, you wouldn't normally do this, but we like people to understand that ACE doesn't really have any limitations as far as what it can read from and write to. So be careful in who you give access to create ACE calculations, and keep an eye on the ACE calculations themselves and make sure they're not modifying any historical or process data. Now at this time, we would turn to the class and ask them, what are some of the access privileges needed by the ACE applications, and in particular, the ACE wizard? And the response we would be looking for would be general read-write access to the module database on the PI server. And that's the access you need.